Look, Mr. Ronaldo, it sounds like a stupid deal. But believe me, it's a good deal. $45 billion. For your company.
Very good deal, but Atlasair makes about $1.1 trillion. A year, how much do you all make?
Mr. Ronaldo, we make about $1.5 trillion a year, and all we do is deliver cargo around America.
And Mexico.
But Atlasair delivers all seven continents. Asia, Africa, North and South America, Europe. And Australia.
Dude, that's six continents, even though why single quotes all dot travel about six continents, we still make more me than y'all, and Union Pacific builds half of America?
Mr. Ronaldo, Union Pacific is trying to get to aviation, and this is yours opportunity to sell us Atlasair. Y'all can be filthy rich.
Look, Mr. Ronaldo, my wife is right, y'all can get rich. Mr. Braxton is a good friend of mine and he is a good person. We are just trying to make the world a better place, not just America.
Ruv is right, look Ronaldo, I promise you won't regret the deal, it's a good deal. How about this, y'all sell Atlasair to us? And you still make money, we can split it.
Ronaldo, I kinda like this deal. You should sell the company. Come on, it's a bigger company they've been doing this for. 160 years we haven't been successful ever since we bought Boeing 7 for 7 seconds.
I guess, but does a railroad company really want a cargo airline?
Ronaldo, I can really tell you I really need your airline if everyone needs it. I'm rich as shit, I don't need the money, I'm investing everything I got. And buy big companies like you and make it better than before, I promise I've been investing since I was 18. And I'm fucking 49.
Alright, I'm selling the company, sold.
No way, we did it, we fucking did it.
Congratulations, Braxton, you own Atlasair.
Woo, we did it, Atlasair is ours, I wish I can. Kiss you, Ronaldo.
What?
Nothing.
Let's go, we got a new company, Union Pacific stays strong.
Congrats, Braxton.
GG, Union Pacific.
Babe, you did it. I'm so proud of you.
Thanks, baby, I guess I won't have to deal with Atlasair anymore.
Hey, Ruv, I really appreciate what you did in that meeting, cause of that you made Ronaldo sell Atlasair, cause of that you're now a executive for Union Pacific and Atlasair.
Wow, Julian, you don't have to make me an executive for Union Pacific and Atlasair, I really appreciate that. So you trying to get a beer for celebration?
Yeah, let's go get a beer, let's go to Hooters.
All right, bet.
That Nate was lit. I think I need to drink some more booze.
IUV, where have you been? It's been 2 days since I seen you. Have you been with Braxton?
I know Wildly now, but I felt very tired.
All right, go to bed. It's gonna dot be your big day tomorrow.
Man, it's been a while getting on a train. I'm starting to miss my job at Union Pacific.
Wow, I never ever had a chance to drive a Boeing 747-8 freighter.
Yeah, I know, it's our first time letting a executive drive a cargo plane. So obviously a Boeing 747-8 freighter, four engines. This plane was built in 2015.So it was recent. We are the biggest cargo airline with the most Boeing 747 with a fleet size of 54 of these aircrafts.
Damn, y'all got a huge fleet of 747 seconds. But yeah, where's Johnny?
I don't know, maybe he's getting on the plane.
Guys, I'm here, let's turn on this bitch and go to Los Angeles, California. All right, Ruv, don't worry, just pull the throttle.
And then pull the steering wheel once you feel like you're ready to take off. Atlas Air Flight 450, why the hell are you at? The runway Cantus Flight 1354 has to take off. Right now.
We have an executive driving the plane, don't worry, he's experienced, he knows what he's doing.
All right, I don't give an effect, just continue your journey.
Blow it, we put the bomb on Atlas Air Flight for 50. When are you gonna bomb the plane?
Let's make Braxton lose a company. How about right fucking no, yay?
Wait, what the fuck? Oh shit, we lost an engine.
Ruv, come on, control the damn plane. We are losing control two of our engines. Exploded.
We're gonna fucking die.
Well, I knew this was gonna happen. Goodbye, guys, it was fun meeting y'all.
Breaking news, Atlas Air Flight 450 exploded 5 minutes after it took off. It's still unknown how the plane exploded, but we know three pilots and one executive ended up dying in the crash. So the executive that died was 47-year-old Ruvisvat Straz.
Wait, what? And no, he can't be dead. Where's the plane? Intact. Wait, how though it exploded?
Yep, they're 100% dead. We found this piece in the ocean. Looks like Atlas Air Flight 450 was all destroyed. We can't even find the wings we only found, the cargo and engine pieces and some landing gear. Worst part is we haven't found none of the bodies.
Ha fucking idiots, we're gonna take down Atlas Air. So long fucking idiot Ruvisvat haha. Ha.
Wait, who did you said again?
That fucking idiot Ruvisvat, he's dead, I'm glad I planted. The bomb on the plane, no, he's dead, ha 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 ha.
Wait, W-H-A-T. Sue, what's your name?
Name's Ruvisvat, just started working here 2 years ago. What about you?
I've been working here for 13 years, since 1995.
Oh, that's nice trying to be friends.
Yeah, sure. Why not? You got my best friend killed.
Wait, what?
You son of a bitch got my best friend killed. You fucking bitch, why? I fucking hate you. He's the reason why I was always happy I hate you. Out of all of every flight, you chose 450, you fucking bitch. My best friend is dead, Bcouse your ass, don't have real friends. Ruvisvat was my only true friend. I joined y'all to help y'all, but I don't think I want to be in this shitty cartel group, fuck you.
Look, Lloyd, I'm sorry, I am extremely sorry I chose that plane. Please, we need you to plant more bombs so we can ruin Atlas Air.
No, fuck that. My life is already ruined. I'm a fucking criminal that has a bygas bounty I've been missing from. Home over more than 2 months, my friend is dead, I have. Nothing, fuck you, I fucking hate you, fuck everything. You have. Ruv was the only friend I had, and he made me happy, he even bought me a car, that's how of a true friend he was, I regret pressing that butt. I'm a fucking kill you, you fucking no soul ass bitch.
Hey nigga, chill, I swear chill, I'm sorry I killed your friend. Of yours, a nigga, don't pull the trigger. I'm sorry, Lloyd, please give me another chance, it won't happen. Again.
Huh, well, looks like it's too late, buddy. I'm killing you, but since you're gonna die, all I'm gonna say is that I hope everything you love also dies, you sick son of a bitch.
Lloyd, I'm sorry for you.
Man looks like he's dead. I lost a expensive ass plane and a best friend. Fuck the plane, I care about my best friend more than anything. I'm gonna donate Sarvainty at least $50 million. I feel extremely bad for her. Man, what a sad day. I'm gonna make a memorial livery for my planes and my trains. Rest in peace, Ruvisvat.
Fuck everything, I can't believe Ruv's dead, it's such a heartbreaking moment. Well, I'm going back home. Think I should just go see Ruv's funeral. I want to make him feel happy. Shit. Where am I? Looks like I'm in Eagle Pass, Texas. Alright, I guess I'm gonna have to do the hard way. I guess the funeral is in 3 weeks. So I have time. Alright, so I need a bus ride or sim shit like that. I gotta get a bus ride to Katy, Texas.
Where am I? Man, where the hell am I? Shit, looks like I'm stuck in the ocean. Looks like I'm in the islands of Cuba. Alright, looks like it's one of Cuba's island resorts. At least they better have an airport for me to get out. Alright, I'm here, and wow, everything looks beautiful.
Hey dude, that plane crash looks so gnarly, and why are you wearing a suit that is ripped everywhere?
I'm the pilots that survived Atlas Air Flight 450.
Really, dude? You survived that? That plane exploded in pieces.
Somehow I survived.
Come on, I'ma take you to the police.so they can take you where you came from.
Alright, I gotta get back home.
Man, I don't think I'm a third of a way done. To Katy, Texas, I don't think I'ma make it to Ruv's funeral. Well, I'ma try my best. It's in less than 3 weeks, I think. Wait, what?
Move and get your head blown off. I know you are a former Union Pacific engineer. Shit, I have no time. I don't care though, I want you to hijack a train. Follow me, bitch.
Okay, please. I don't want to die.
Well, thank God I'm getting deported back to my country, and no, I just gotta stay in this plane till I get to the George Bush Intercontinental Airport.
Well, can't believe I'ma drive a train after a while out of Union Pacific, but this time, I guess I will have to do railing.
Okay, Lloyd, once you're inside, I will get in.
Copy. Okay, so what are we gonna do with the hijacked train?
We are gonna crash it with another train. That's like 10 miles away from here. And don't worry, it won't seem like much, but this train is carrying tankers that are probably the size of a Russian missile. Don't worry, B, we'll both jump off, so anyways, let's go.
Fine, let's get this over with.
My radio.
This is Cassidy Buck, say Mafia Boss. Stole a train with a tanker with dangerous goods. I repeat, hijacked train.
Oh shit, fuck this, I gotta jump off the plane. Ah heck, shit, I'm falling. Alright, this Mafia Boss thinks he's good. Well, he's fucking with the wrong person. Lloyd is probably shitting bricks. I'm gonna save him from the Mafia Boss.
Look, why are you doing this?
America needs to be punished. Plus, I hate Julian Braxton.
Why?
Because he ruined so many oil industries, like PMEX Texaco and Mobil.
No, he fucking didn't. He owns a $129.05 billion railroad company, and Atlas Air, a $2.86 billion company. He's rich as shit. Why would he ruin oil industries?
Shut the fuck up, bitch. You heard me, no. Zip it and just drive. We got 7 miles left.
Well, this is it. I'm gonna jump on the train. Well, I hope I survive this fall. If I could survive a deadly plane crash, I could survive this. Let's go, I'm on the train, all right, just in case. I'ma disconnect the train for safety reasons. All right, no, it's time to end all of this.
Well, we only got 4 miles left, so get ready to jump off.
Yay, but why is this fast? It's supposed to be dot in 60 miles per hour, not in 90.
Hey, the freight cars are gone. Fucking bitch, we'll have to go back and get the freight cars.
You ain't doing shit, you son of a bitch.
Well, we'll wheel if it isn't RuvSucksAt the dude. That was after the cartels and the mafia. Well, guess what? We're at least 3 minutes away from our destination. So don't worry, RuvSucksAt, this train is gonna crash. What's the whole point? You can shoot dot at me, you can fucking kill me.
Okay, I will kill you, bitch, goodbye.
Holy shit, you killed him.
Lloyd, jump off, hurry.
So Ruv, you're alive?
Of course, I was Lloyd, my plane crashed and I woke up in Cuba, I was found, I told them too. Deport, be back, found out a train was hijacked. You were in it, and I killed the mafia boss, and here we are.
Well, Ruv, let's go back home. Sarventi has been crying for the past few weeks after your death, but you weren't dead, you were alive.
Yay, let's go back. Lloyd finally got caught and they find out he killed 51 people and he will be in prison for 1 year since he just killed criminals. Then I get Sarventi pregnant with a kid, so there's the third member of my family. Braxton ended up buying 2 railroads, BNSF and Amtrak. He's currently trying to buy UPS and FedEx Airlines. The mafia boss was instantly killed by me and they found his body all crushed up in the locomotive, and the locomotive hit the rail cars so bad that the 2 locomotives that they were unrepaired and scrapped. So yay, everything basically changes when someone sadly passes away.
Yay, edit. Kinda sucks that my brother is in prison for apparently joining a cartel group and all those murders. Goddamn, he's worse than John Wayne Gacy, Dahmer, and Bundy.
Yay, but alright, but Bob, can I tell you something?
Yeah?
Hey Bob, sorry that I freight hopped right in front of you that time when I asked you that if you knew where Lloyd went.
You're good though. You did me and my brother a huge favor. You saved my brother from getting killed by that mafia boss, and I couldn't skip work to find him, but you're good though.
Alright Bob, well I guess it's getting a bit late. I gotta go back home. Bob, you trying to get a beer Saturday?
Yay, sure. Why not? But bye. See ya, Ruv.
Bye.